supposed to be arraigned because their fear is that they will be sent to prison on because of the holiday. That before the time they will perfect their bail. So they were trying not to put all sort of obstacles to against arraignment. And at the end of the day, we were able to succumb that. No, the moment we get the person, we can amend the charge. We can file another charge differently for him. So we are not losing anything.
The plea has been taken. He has pleaded not guilty to the charge. And I believe we will allow the court to take evidence. And at the end of the day, we intend to show to Nigerians that what has led to this charge, insinuations, arose from a civil contract between his companies and the NPDC to lift crude oil and do some services. So the dispute really is about how much he ought to have paid into the government coffer, which he did not. And of course, which over the years, the parties have had several meetings with a view to reconciling figures. And as I'm talking to you today, parties are still meeting to reconcile figures. We as lawyers and as citizens of this country, we do not also support corruption. But there must be a line drawn between what amounts to corrupt practice and a purely civil dispute on which a civil suit can be commenced to recover whatever outstanding sum. So I want you to get our position very clear. Mr. Omakore admits he has an existing agreement with NNPC, and that agreement is still subsisting, but there are disputes as to the quantum of crude lifted and as to how much should go to the federal government.